Hey everyone, I am not on camera this time around since I don't have a lot of shooting space where I'm living right now, so sorry you can't see my beautiful face. Anyway, similar to last year, I want to put an award show thingy celebrating the great films that I saw in 2023. I watched a lot of bangers, probably not as many as last year, but hey, I'm living life, that's what counts. Just like last year, I will be using typical Oscar categories, but I'm throwing in a few of my own, including a section dedicated to television because I just saw some phenomenal shows this year and I want to celebrate all of the talent that I witnessed. I also have the Best Standout Actor Award thingy, which is just basically highlighting a few actors that's work has particularly stood out to me personally this year. All the clips featured here are from films that I watched for the very first time in 2023, and the episodes of the TV shows that I display are from shows that I started in 2023. This is all stuff from 2023 that I watched for the very first time, okay? Hope that clears that up. Most of the awards are self-explanatory, so I won't take up too much of your time. Anyway, hope you're doing well, and let's roll the clip show. The nominees for Best Episodes of Television go to May the Giant Be With You, Twin Peaks.
My son was standing there. He was happy and carefree.
Ronnie Lilly, Barry.
What are you?
Nature, Moral Oral.
Why do you quit working on me? You've done nothing but whine about my drinking since we got here.
It's because you become a bad person when you drink.
Part 8, Twin Peaks The Return.
This is the water of light, and this is the oil.
Episode 10, Normal People.
What do you mean?
Are you on your own?
No, I'm with Helen. What do you mean, a body?
Connor's Wedding, Succession.
Is he okay? What's going on? What is it? Is he okay?
The nominees for Best Supporting Actress in a Television Series. Peggy Lipton in Twin Peaks.
I'd rather be his whore than your wife.
Paula Newsome in Barry.
Did we fucking get it open or not?
I did.
Madchen Amick in Twin Peaks.
He moved! This is too creepy, I don't like this.
Victoria Pedretti in The Haunting of Hill House.
And you tell me I'm crazy, and that Mom was crazy, and Luke's crazy, and we're all just nuts. And then you tell our stories, my stories, the same stories that you told me were just dreams or delusions.
Sarah Green in Normal People.
What exactly is the arrangement? Marianne comes over to our house, you have sex with her, and then she's not allowed to tell anyone, is that it?
What does that mean, allowed?
Do you talk to her in school? In front of your friends, are you nice to her?
Naomi Watts in Twin Peaks The Return.
Okay, so you get this straight. My husband has a job, he has a wife, he has a child, he does not make enough money to pay back $52,000 for anything.
3 days without a word, you don't show up at work, and you miss Sonny Jim's birthday. How could you?
Without my knowledge, my husband came to you for a loan of $20,000. You were nice enough to give it to him, but he should never have been gambling like that. I'm gonna pay you back. Now at my bank, where we make less than 1% interest on what little money we have, people will be turning cartwheels just to get 25% interest on any loan.
Winner, Sherilyn Fenn in Twin Peaks.
Once upon a time, there was a sweet, innocent girl named Red, that's me, and she met a bad old wolf, that's you. And she kicked the crap out of that wolf, and she told her daddy all about it. Then she told the police, and the bad old wolf went to jail for a million years.
What do you want?
God, I love this music. Isn't it too dreamy?
The nominees for Best Supporting Actor in a Television Series. Matthew Good in The Offer.
You got in because you did something that's not done. You saw something that you wanted and you went for it. Woof! You and I are not like these corporate You play by the book, we write the fucking book.
I took a chance on you and you stabbed me in the back. I don't like Pacino!
Anthony Carrigan in Barry.
This is my first interrogation, you know? I'm like legit nervous.
Hey, I'm no cocaine. Thrust of Flight was good, no?
When you say that word, you sound naive.
Richard Beamer in Twin Peaks.
Men fall under the spell of Audrey's charms like ducks in a shooting gallery. And if you don't want a load of buckshot in your tail feathers, may I suggest that you park your jalopy outside of somebody else's window.
Henry Winkler in Barry.
Little Sally Reed from Joplin, Missouri. What do you want? I want you to stay away from my family. F*** you and don't talk to me anymore, you piece of sh-.
Dana Ashbrook in Twin Peaks.
Amen!
Something snapped. It was like my brain rolled over and I could see all of the stuff that was special to me.
You damn hypocrites make me sick! Everybody knew she was in trouble. But we didn't do anything. Afraid? I'm gonna turn it upside down!
Matthew McFadden in Succession.
I think a lot of the time, if I think about it, I think a lot of the time, I'm really pretty unhappy.
It's not my fault that you didn't get his approval. I have given you endless approval, and it doesn't fill you up because you're broken.
Winner, Ray Wise in Twin Peaks.
Have you ever experienced absolute loss?
I doubt if any one of us is a stranger to grief.
No, more than grief.
Please, please.
It's deep down, inside. Every cell screams. You can hear nothing else. Yes.
The nominees for Best Actress in a Television Series, Emma Stone in The Curse.
Like, you laughing in my face is not okay. You need to show me the respect I deserve.
His mom, oh, Ashley, oh, you're so sweet. Oh, wow, nice to meet you. Who's this?
Do not put words in my mouth. I was speaking karmically.
Hannah Waddingham in Ted Lasso.
I saw you with your assistant. Your daughter deserves better, and so does Bex. Stop f***ing around.
You want way more than that. You're just so convinced that you don't deserve anything good in your life that you'd rather eat a bowl of soup and then complain about the portions.
This club is all that Rupert has ever cared about, and I wanted to destroy it.
Laura Dern in Twin Peaks The Return.
It was 3, maybe 4 years after I stopped hearing from Cooper. I was still working at the Bureau. No knock. No doorbell. I just walked in.
When was that, Cooper? When did we see each other last?
As soon as his lips touched mine, something went wrong.
Sarah Goldberg in Barry.
What if I get it wrong? I mean, I resent the fact that Nick can get up there and talk about his stomach condition, and it's not like he has to be the poster boy for bulimia, but I get up there and whatever I say, it's like, what are we saying about women? And I am f***ing drowning, and instead of trying to help me, you're just trying to save yourself. This is honest, okay? This is the honest f***ing truth. And if that makes me unhirable, then I am f***ing unhirable, but at least I told the f***ing truth.
Daisy Edgar Jones in Normal People.
I would never pretend to not know you, Connell.
And if you think that people should be able to go to college and get English degrees and go to Europe and look at ours, then you shouldn't feel guilty for yourself because you have every right to.
There's been a lot of stuff that's been difficult and painful. And this would be difficult and amazing.
Potentially, yes.
It's New York.
Winner, Sarah Snook in Succession.
So maybe, you know, I can get a little consideration on that. And for, you know, a number of reasons, I've been feeling off kilter, so.
Don't go, please, not now.
You took away the last 6 months I could have had with my dad.
No.
Yes.
No.
Yes. You sucked up to him and you cut me out.
The nominees for Best Actor in a Television Series, Jason Sudeikis in Ted Lasso.
I think that's what it's all about. Embracing change.
Hell, I'm coaching soccer, for heaven's sake.
In London.
I mean, that's nuts. I was just so angry at him. Because he was always gone at work and just out with friends or something like that. And then he was gone.
Kyle MacLachlan in Twin Peaks.
Do you know where dreams come from?
Not specifically.
Acetylcholine neurons fire high-voltage impulses into the forebrain. These impulses become pictures, the pictures become dreams, but no one knows why we choose these particular pictures.
How's Andy? How's Andy?
Bill Hader in Barry.
I believe, and some of this I got from your teachings, that you can be the version of yourself that you want to be.
I love you, Mr. Kuzno.
If I saw you walking down the street, I'd f***ing kill you, I'd kill your f***ing kids, I'd kill your f***ing wife, and I'd kill your f***ing mom.
Kieran Culkin in Succession.
You f***ing killed him, too. You're the one who did it. You drained the life out of him. You dragged this thing out for 6 f***ing months, and then you bring us out here now. You couldn't wait like a few days. You actually couldn't do that for us.
My time. I can do it. I want it, and I think I can do it.
I actually can't do that anymore. I tried to sing. All I'm saying, I'm not being crazy. I'm saying a fact. I'm saying we don't know. And until we do know, it's not a very nice thing to say, is it?
Okay.
So fucking stop.
Is he in there?
Yeah.
Can we get him out?
Paul Mescal in Normal People.
I can't really talk to anybody the way that I talk to you or anything like that.
We were 18, you know, we just... We act like idiots.
I don't really know what to say other than the fact that I miss you and I really love you, Marianne.
I left currently thinking I could have a different life. But I hate it here and I can never go back. Because those friendships are gone and and Rob is gone, and I can't see him again.
Winner, Jeremy Strong in Succession.
I don't want to be you. I'm a good guy.
I would just ask that you take care of me. Because if Dad didn't need me right now, I don't exactly know what I would be for.
It doesn't even make any sense! I'm the youngest boy!
It wasn't a room from the grandest stateroom where his advice was sought to the lowest house where his news played, where he couldn't walk and wasn't comfortable. He was comfortable with this world.
The nominees for Best Standout Actors go to Issa Rae, Christopher Abbott, Rooney Mara, Cillian Murphy, Willem Dafoe, Jacob Elordi, Ryan Gosling, winner Kyle MacLachlan. The nominees for Best Chemistry go to Jennifer Lawrence and Andrew Barth Feldman in No Hard Feelings.
Are you allowed to be here?
Oh yeah, I know the owner, it's fine.
It's just that I'm not 21.
That doesn't matter here.
Well, I think it's a federal law.
Daniel Day-Lewis and Vicky Krieps in Phantom Thread.
Who are you? Do you have a gun? You here to kill me?
Stop it!
Where's your gun?
Stop being a
Where's
child.
Where's your gun?
Stop
Show playing. Me your gun.
Stop playing this game.
I'm not playing a game.
Yes, mm-hmm.
What game am I playing? What game? What precisely is the nature of my game?
Seth Rogen and Charlize Theron in Long Shot.
He just brought me here to see Boys to Men.
I just met them.
You met the men?
Yeah.
What was it like?
Don't tell anybody, but it was the highlight of my life.
Oh, I can't even get that.
And I've met the Dalai Lama.
Damn, how many hits does he have? None. Don't actually. He's a wonderful man.
Yeah.
Del Williams in Blue Valentine.
All right.
I got it.
I make money.
Okay, I got it.
Money I can take girls out on dates with. Just so you know.
Good to know. Mm-hmm. Okay.
Winner? Paul Mescal and Daisy Edgar-Jones in Normal People. I know I'm cheating, but I don't care.
That's easy for you to say. You don't feel guilty about anything.
Is that how you see me?
I love the emails you sent. They were so good. You write really beautifully.
It's really nice to hear you say that, Marianne.
How are the stories going? I'd love to read them.
They're not as good as the emails.
The nominees for Best Ending go to Oppenheimer, The Player, Perfect Blue, Killers of the Flower Moon, Twin Peaks Fire Walk With Me, The Last Temptation of Christ, Blue Valentine, Winner, All That Jazz. The nominees for Best Ensemble Cast go to Asteroid City, Bottoms, Woman Talking, Blue Velvet, Oppenheimer, Apocalypse Now, Winner, The Four Seasons. The nominees for Best Production Design go to Volver, But I'm a Cheerleader, Barbie, Bo is Afraid, Birdman or the Unexpected Virtue of Ignorance, Apocalypse Now, Winner, Poor Things. The nominees for Best Film Editing go to Feels Good Man, edited by Aaron Wickenden, Katrina Taylor, and Drew Blatton. Apocalypse Now, edited by Walter Murch, Lisa Fruitman, and Gerald B. Greenberg. All That Jazz, edited by Alan Hayne. Miami Vice, edited by William Goldenberg and Paul Rubel. Once Upon a Time in the West, edited by Nino Baragli. Edited by Jose Salcito. Uncut Gems, edited by Benny Safdie and Ronald Bronstein.
There it is. It's 110 million years old. The leaks.
It will pass the moon, past the
rock. Can't lean on the glass here.
All right. Killers of the Flower Moon, edited by Thelma Schoonmaker.
Kelsey Morrison and his wife was in the back seat. He took Anna and got her good and drunk. And they were all together. Kelsey, Byron, and Anna. I ain't lying.
Kelsey Morrison. Kelsey Morrison runs dope and whiskey from Fort Worth to New Orleans to Dallas.
Dog Day Afternoon, edited by Dee Dee Allen. Oppenheimer, edited by Jennifer Lane. The nominees for Best Sound Design go to Napoleon, The Exorcist, Blue Velvet, Oppenheimer. Winner, Uncut Gems. The nominees for Best Original Score go to Spider-Man Across the Spider-Verse, composed by Daniel Pemberton. Paris, Texas, composed by Rye Cooter. Twin Peaks Fire Walk With Me, composed by Angelo Badalamenti. Uncut Gems, composed by Daniel Lopatin. A Fistful of Dollars, composed by Ennio Morricone. Phantom Thread, composed by Johnny Greenwood. Birdman or the Unexpected Virtue of Ignorance, composed by Antonio Sanchez. Winner, Oppenheimer, composed by Ludwig Göransson. The nominees for Best Animated Feature go to Only Yesterday, directed by Isao Takahata. Claws, directed by Sergio Pablos. The Boy and the Heron, directed by Hayao Miyazaki. Spider-Man Across the Spider-Verse, directed by Joaquin Dos Santos, Justin K. Thompson, and Kemp Powers. Winner, Perfect Blue, directed by Satoshi Kon. The nominees for Best Original Screenplay go to Accepted, written by Adam Cooper, Bill Collage, and Mark Perez.
Who cares about your approval? We don't need your approval to tell us that what we did was real. Because there are so few truths in this world that when you see one, you know it. And I know that it is a truth that real learning took place at South Harmon. Whether you like it or not, it did. Because you don't need teachers or classrooms or fancy highbrow traditions or money to really learn. You just need people with a desire to better themselves. And we got that by the shitload at South Harmon.
The Discovery, written by Justin Ladder and Charlie McDowell.
Death used to be something we just had to live with, and now it's a convenient way to escape pain. That's okay.
That's okay. Another plane of existence, maybe. Who knows? But I look around, I see a lot of people jumping out of planes hoping that they're going to grow wings. And reality and fantasy are mutually exclusive. They don't exist in the same space.
Phantom Thread, written by Paul Thomas Anderson.
Go ahead and do it, but please don't let her sit around waiting for you. I'm very fond of her.
Well, you're very fond of her, are you? Well, in that case...
No, don't turn it on me. I don't want your cloud on my head.
Shut up, Sue.
You can shut right up. Don't pick a fight with me. You certainly won't come out alive. I'll go right through you, and it'll be you who ends up on the floor. Understood?
Fair Play, written by Chloe Domont.
You think I need you people to get ahead, to make something of myself? I don't need you people. I am going to make it on my own skill and my own merit, and when I do, I'm going to run your f***ing company into the ground.
Vengeance, written by B.J. Novak.
We both know how this works, right? Yeah, I mean, at first, everyone's gonna think you got your bad guy. Nobody's gonna let it be that simple. Everyone's gonna have to have their take, because that's how it works now. Everyone has a take. If you don't have a take, you don't have a voice. If you don't have a voice, you don't exist. So yeah, at first, everyone's gonna blame me. But then someone's gonna say, wait a second. There's a big difference between leaving somebody to die and killing somebody.
Sanction Confused, written by Richard Linklater.
Did you get it bad when you were a freshman?
Man. They waited for my ass after baseball practice. Got me. God, it was vicious. I mean, actually, it is best to get a lot at once, you know, because after about 10 licks, your ass gets so numb, you might as well get it over with.
Asteroid City, written by Wes Anderson.
Somebody else's story. A man thinks up a number, divides it by a trillion, plugs it into the square root of the circumference of the Earth, multiplied by the speed of a splitting atom, and voila, progress. I'm not a scientist. You are. End of chapter 3. Junior stargazers and space cadets, we watch transfixed as you enter into uncharted territories of the brains and spirit. If you wanted to live a nice, quiet, peaceful life, you picked the wrong time to get born.
Paris, Texas, written by Sam Shepard and L.M. Kit Carson.
He thought if she never got jealous of him, that she didn't really care about him.
Jealousy was a sign of her love for him. And then one night, she told him that she was pregnant. She was about 3 or 4 months pregnant, and he didn't even know. And then suddenly everything changed. He stopped drinking and got a steady job. He was convinced that she loved him now because she was carrying his child.
Winner, The Four Seasons, written by Alan Alda.
So that when you get to be my age, you don't smell the foul breath of death and disintegration hanging over your shoulder the way I find it hanging over mine. I mean, I go to sleep at night on an ache so bad that it simply will not go away. I wake up in the middle of the night sweating, hearing my own bones decay. I have shifted into a state of entropy that's progressing geometrically.
You see? Entropy. Progressing geometrically. You talk like a bad textbook. Why don't you just speak English?
God damn it! I just told you my deepest fear! Why can't you listen to what I'm saying instead of how I'm saying?
The nominees for Best Adapted Screenplay go to Are You There, God? It's Me, Margaret, written by Kelly Freeman Craig.
What I learned about religion is that it makes people fight. And every religion says the same thing. If you pray to God, he'll listen to you and help you and make things better. But I've prayed and prayed, and everything just gets worse.
Carrie, written by Lawrence D. Cohen.
And spit out that gum.
Well, I put it, Miss Collins. You can choke on it for all I care. Just get it out of your mouth. Did any of you ever stop to think that Carrie White has feelings? Do any of you ever stop to think?
Pride and Prejudice, written by Deborah Mogat.
And I might as well inquire why, with so evident a design of insulting me, you chose to tell me that you like me against your better judgment.
No, believe me,
I was uncivil, then that is some excuse, but I have other reasons. You know I have.
What reasons?
Do you think that anything might tempt me to accept a man who has ruined, perhaps forever, the happiness of a most beloved sister? Do you deny it, Mr. Darcy? That you separated a young couple who loved each other, exposing your friend to the center of the world for caprice and my sister to its derision for disappointed hopes, and involving them both in misery of the acutest kind.
I do not deny it.
Poor Things, written by Tony McNamara.
I find myself nearly jealous of the men's time with you, rather than any moral aspersion against you. It is your body, Bella Baxter, yours to give freely.
I generally charge 30 francs.
Well, that seems low.
Dog Day Afternoon, written by Frank Pearson.
I'm scared to death, that's why. What, you don't smoke?
No.
How come?
I don't want the cancer.
Oh my God. Give me the cigarette.
Go ahead, do what you want. I just think you ought to take care of your body, that's all.
My body? What for?
Your body is the temple of the Lord.
You're serious? So you rob a bank, but you keep your body pure. Is that it?
You're gonna smoke the cigarette or what?
Killers of the Flower Moon, written by Eric Roth and Martin Scorsese.
It's so simple! The front is the front, the back is the back!
He has to make it look like he done himself!
It just looks like murder. It's not supposed to be that way. You hear?
I told him the front of the head. I said the front of the head, just like this, just like you told me. I promise you, I swear on my children.
No.
I swear on my children, Kane.
Sit. Don't swear on your children. Makes you look foolish.
The Last Temptation of Christ, written by Paul Schrader.
We all sin.
Not my sins. I'm a liar. A hypocrite. I'm afraid of everything. I don't ever tell the truth. I don't have the courage. When I see a woman, I blush and look away. I want her, but I don't take her for God. And that makes me proud. And then my pride ruins Magdalene. I don't steal, I don't fight, I don't kill, not because I don't want to, but because I'm afraid. I want to rebel against you, against everything, against God, but I'm afraid.
Apocalypse Now, written by Francis Ford Coppola, John Milius, and Michael Hare.
I'm afraid that both you and your mother will have been worried at not hearing from me during the past weeks, but my situation here has become a difficult one. I have been officially accused of murder by the army. The alleged victims were four Vietnamese double agents. We spent months uncovering them and accumulating evidence. When absolute proof was completed, we acted. We acted like soldiers. The charges are unjustified.
Winner, The Player, written by Michael Tolkien.
Now, you can't make a deal, that's what they say. Yesterday's news.
Wait a minute.
Can I borrow your mobile phone?
Huh?
Larry Levy. Yeah, Larry. David Kahane here. Listen, Larry, guess who's making promises about getting pictures made to writers in parking lots? Guess what dumb son of a bitch executive is trying to take advantage of me? I mean, do you realize how unstoppable this guy is? You know, I cannot wait to tell the world that when Griffin Mill can't cut the pressure at work, he drives out to Pasadena to pick fights with writers!
The nominees for Best Cinematography go to Saltburn, shot by Linus Sandgren. Once Upon a Time in the West, shot by Tonino Delicoli. Apocalypse Now, shot by Vittorio Storaro. A Ghost Story, shot by Andrew Droz Palomo. The Player, shot by Jean Lepine. Asteroid City, shot by Robert D. Yeoman and Tristan Oliver. Maestro, shot by Matthew Lipitique. Birdman, or The Unexpected Virtue of Ignorance, shot by Emmanuel Lubezki. Phantom Thread, shot by Paul Thomas Anderson. Winner, Paris, Texas, shot by Robbie Mueller. The nominees for Best Actress in a Supporting Role, Hong Chau in The Whale.
Like a cancer, he couldn't shake it. He just caved in on himself, stopped sleeping, stopped eating, lost a ton of weight. One night, he doesn't come home. A couple weeks later, this guy's out jogging on a bike path near the river in Lewiston, sees something washed up on shore, and that was Alan.
Piper Laurie in Carrie.
After the blood come the boys, like sniffing dogs, running and slobbering and trying to find out where that smell comes from.
Sandy Dennis in The Four Seasons.
But I tend to lose track. I get on the bus and I forget where I'm going, and I will watch the streets go by. And I just hope to God that one of them will remind me what I'm there for.
Rachel McAdams in Are You There, God? It's Me, Margaret.
They told me that it would be very hard for them to have a Jewish son-in-law. They told me it would be very hard for them to have a Jewish son-in-law. And that if I wanted to marry him, that was my business, but I wouldn't be their daughter anymore.
Lashana Lynch in The Woman King.
When I had 14 years, my mother put a sign out to sell my virginity. The first man came, and I cried for my mother, but she didn't come. The second man came and complained of my tears, so she beat me. The third man came, and I burned him with an ember.
Jesse Buckley in Women Talking.
It would be better to stay and fight than leave.
Do you really mean that you want to stay and not fight? To protect your children or to get out of harm's way?
You! To tell me what kind of wife and mother to be when you are neither one yourself. You are a spinster, a whore.
Patti LuPone in Beau Is Afraid.
My own mother wouldn't even touch me. Not if it was simply to stamp me out if I was on fire. I wasn't worthy of her love. I hadn't earned it, and I never earned it, no matter what I did. No matter how much of my deepest, real self I denied and buried and smothered until it was dead, none of it mattered.
Kathy Moriarty in But I'm a Cheerleader.
Aha! You see, you don't even think it's wrong. Until you admit your sickness, you will wear these. You will earn the right to wear civvies once you have admitted the first step. It's a long path to righteousness, Megan. Foreplay is for sissies. Real men go in, unload, and pull out.
Nastasha Kinski in Paris, Texas.
I used to make up long speeches to you after you left. I used to talk to you all the time. Even though I was alone, I walked around for months talking to you.
Winner, Divine Joy Randolph in The Holdovers.
You don't tell a boy that's been left behind at Christmas that you're aching to cut him loose, that nobody wants him? What the f*** is wrong with you?
He's gone.
The nominees for Best Actor in a Supporting Role, Robert De Niro in Killers of the Flower Moon.
I mean, there might be a public outcry for a while, but then you know what happens? People forget. They don't remember. They don't care. They just don't care. It's just gonna be another everyday common tragedy.
With these women dying, with how Osage suffered from illness,
you have to make it the head rats come to you.
Nathan Lane in Beau Is Afraid.
I want to say tonight, but I already pushed this morning's surgeries to tomorrow. But if I pull them all back to this afternoon, we could blast off tomorrow morning. Is it, Beau? Don't just say that. This is your decision.
Ving Rhames in Bringing Out the Dead.
Action, one more chance for a sinner. Please, Lord, bring back. I be banging, Lord. You have the power, Jesus. You have the might. You have the super light to spare this worthless man.
Ryan Gosling in Barbie.
That's why I was created. I only exist within the warmth of your gaze. Without it, I'm just another blood god who can't do flips.
Henry Cerny in Mission Impossible Dead Reckoning Part 1.
The next world war isn't going to be a cold one. It's going to be a shooting war. It's going to be a ballistic war over a rapidly shrinking ecosystem. It's going to be a war for the last of our dwindling energy, drinkable water, breathable air. Whoever controls the entity controls the truth. The concepts of right and wrong can be clearly defined for everyone for centuries to come.
Kevin Garnett in Uncut Gems.
$100,000 for something you thought was worth $1 million. You don't see nothing wrong with that album?
What do you mean it's not for sale?
I can't do it. That, goddammit, it's set for auction. I can't.
How the f*** would you show me something if I couldn't have it then? $1 million is more, is my point. You understand?
John McEnroe in Past Lives.
Childhood. Sweethearts who reconnect 20 years later only to realize they were meant for each other. In the story, I would be the evil white American husband standing in the way of destiny.
Dennis Hopper in Blue Velvet.
No thanks. What does that mean?
I don't want to go.
Go where?
For a ride.
A ride! Now that's a good idea. Okay, let's go.
What kind of beer do you like?
Heineken! That's Pabst Blue Ribbon!
Charles Melton in May, December.
Yo, you have not been sympathetic. Why can't we talk about it? If we're really as in love as we say we are, if we have that, where shouldn't I be able to talk about this with you? I feel like everything's so fucked up.
It's not that. It's all right.
I just want you to have a good life.
Because bad things, they happen. And we do bad things also. We have to think about those things. We try not to think about it. There's this. Do you know what I mean?
Yeah, I know, yeah.
God, I can't tell if we're connecting, if I'm creating a bad memory for you in real time, but I can't help it.
No, we're connecting, Dad. It's okay.
Winner, Marlon Brando in Apocalypse Now.
And at the same time, we're able to utilize their primordial instincts to kill without feeling, without passion, without judgment, without judgment, because it's judgment that defeats us. What is necessary to those who do not know what horror means.
The nominees for Best Actress in a Leading Role, Ayo Edebiri in Bottoms.
But everybody knows he's fruity. Everybody knows he's f***ing fruity. By the way, our son Hezekiah hates us because he knows we're both closeted. We try to make it work for him, but he's not happy. And yeah, guess what? The deacon's f***ing the evangelist, man. He's f***ing the evangelist. I don't want to live like that.
Gloria Swanson in Sunset Boulevard.
There was a time in this business when they had the eyes of the whole wide world. But that wasn't good enough for them. Oh, no. They had to have the ears of the world, too. So they opened their big mouths, and out came talk. Talk, talk. Look at them in the front offices. The masterminds. They took the idols and smashed them. The Fairbankses, the Gilberts, the Valentinos.
Margaret Qualley in Sanctuary.
I thought it would go away. I did. I thought it would go away, but it didn't. It got worse and worse. Why do you think that I started taping the sessions? It was for me.
You don't even fucking know what happened. I taught you how to ask for what you want. You couldn't do that before you met
me. People are watching your company right now. This transition, it would be a story. Heir to Hotel Fortune shoves cotton swab into own people and commanded. Denver Dominatrix tells all.
Pamela Mendoza in Song Without a Name. Vicky Cripps in Phantom Thread.
Waiting for you to get rid of me. To tell me to leave. So tell me. So I don't stand around like a fucking fool.
Asparagus. Is this all about your asparagus?
No, it's not about asparagus.
And then he's ready to start again. And I can stand endlessly. No one can stand as long as I can.
Lily Gladstone, Killers of the Flower Moon.
It does not do to talk to this man. Evil surrounds my heart. Many times I cry, and this evil around my heart comes out of my eyes. I close my heart and keep what is good there. But hate comes, and I say I ought to kill these white men who killed my family.
Penelope Cruz in Volver.
Mira, siempre lo dicen, no me lo creo. Robarle a la tía lo poquito que tenía de valor estando todavía de cuerpo presente. Qué poca vergüenza. Pero no me ha dado buena espina. Yo creo que lo quiere como tapadera.
¿Tapadera? ¿De qué?
Pues de drogas, o para poner un puticlub, no sé. Cuando le he comentado que el negocio no funcionaba, él me ha respondido que mucho mejor.
Ellen Burstyn in The Exorcist.
And I don't care what you call it, I'm not putting her away.
Well, of course I'm sure. I'll tell you.
You're sorry, Jesus Christ, 88 doctors, and all you can tell me was all of your bull-
What are you talking about, for Christ's sakes? Did you see her or not? She's acting like she's out of her mind, psychotic, like a split personality or-
Sissy Spacek in Carrie.
Please see that I'm not like you, Mom. I'm funny. I mean, all the kids think I'm funny. I don't want to be. I want to be normal. I want to start to try and be a whole person before it's too late for me to... And he promised to stop him and
leave
you before him. And I mean, Mama, I'm
accepting,
Mama.
No,
Winner, Cheryl Lee in Twin Peaks, Fire Walk With Me.
There are pages torn out. That is real, Harold.
Oh, my God. Oh, my God.
Bob is real. He's been having me since I was 12.
No.
Fire. Walk with me.
Faster and faster. For a long time, you wouldn't feel anything. Then you'd burst into fire.
The nominees for Best Actor in a Leading Role, Daniel Day-Lewis in Phantom Thread.
I miss you. I think about you all the time. I hear your voice say my name when I dream. And when I wake up, there are tears streaming down my face.
Jason Miller in The Exorcist.
It's my mother, Tom. She's alone. I never should have left her. At least in New York, I'd be near her, I'd be close to her.
You could see about a transfer, Daniel.
I need reassignment, Tom. I want out of this job. It's wrong. It's no good.
You're the best we've got.
I think I've lost my faith, Tom.
Willem Dafoe in The Last Temptation of Christ.
I didn't fight hard enough. Father, give me your hand. I want to bring salvation. Father, take me back. Make a feast. Welcome me home. I want to be your son. I want to pay the price. I want to be crucified and rise again. I want to be the Messiah.
Al Pacino in Dog Day Afternoon.
Kill me so bad he can taste it.
Oh, God, I was going to kill
him. Erica! 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 Erica!
Come on!
supposed to do, you know? A man can't control what they say on television. Well, what do you expect me to do? I mean, I'm doing everything I can. I can't do that.
Paul Giamatti in The Holdovers.
I mean, I used to think I could prepare them for the world, even a little. Mm-hmm. Provide standards and grounding like Dr. Green always drilled into us, but the world doesn't make sense anymore. It's on fire.
That it is not my fault that you are stuck here. Do you think I want to be babysitting you? Oh, no, no. I was praying to the God I don't even believe in that your mother would pick up the phone or your father would arrive in a helicopter or a submarine or a flying f***ing saucer to take you
up. My father's
dead.
Because no one is his own father. I'm not my dad, no matter how hard he tried to beat that idea into me.
Ryan Gosling in Lars and the Real Girl.
And I think it's because she's insecure, but she's just always trying to hug everybody. You know, some people don't like that. Some people don't like to be hugged. But she doesn't realize that. She takes it personally and thinks, you know, it hurts her feelings.
Did you hear that? Bianca just said that that's why God made her, to help people.
Harry Dean Stanton in Paris, Texas.
He never looked back at the fire. He just ran. He ran until the sun came up, and he couldn't run any further. When the sun went down, he ran again.
I'm leaving.
I didn't tell you this in order to make you leave. I'm not trying to get rid of you, Travis.
No, no.
Well, what good is that going to do? That's not going to solve anything.
No, I'm going to find Jane.
If you turn the light off in there, will you be able to see me?
Martin Sheen in Apocalypse Now.
At first, I thought they handed me the wrong dossier. I couldn't believe they wanted this man dead. Third generation West Point, top of his class, Korea, airborne, about 1,000 decorations. I'd heard his voice on the tape and it really put the hook in me. But I couldn't connect up that voice with this man. He was being groomed for one of the top slots in the corporation. General, chief of staff, anything.
Cillian Murphy in Oppenheimer.
Quantum mechanics says it's both. How? And yet, it works.
I wouldn't. And all I could. No, it was me.
I feel that I have blood on my hands.
I'm so proud. So proud of what you have accomplished. If we did it, they would have to do it. Our efforts would only fuel their efforts, just as it had with the atomic bomb.
Winner, Roy Scheider, in All That Jazz.
You're gonna do it again, Victoria. Gary, Danny, let's go. Stop smiling. It's not the high school play.
Who was the director of Traffic Jam?
You were Mr. Gideon.
Oh. How was I?
Terrific.
And who was the choreographer?
You were Mr. Gideon.
How was it?
Fantastic.
That's how you get a job.
You've got to be kidding. I got a show to put on. Jonesy, for Christ's sakes, will you talk to these people? They don't understand anything.
You blew it. You forgot your line. At the end of this number, you're supposed to say, what's he supposed to say?
He's supposed to say, I don't want to die, I want to live.
Well, look, if you can't say it, you can't say it. We'll just have to cut it, that's all. Cut it. Take me up, next setup.
The nominees for Best Director, Paul Verhoeven, Showgirls. David Lynch, Twin Peaks, Fire Walk With Me. Ari Aster, Bo is Afraid. David Lowery, A Ghost Story. Joe Wright, Pride and Prejudice. Satoshi Kon, Perfect Blue. Bob Fosse, All That Jazz. Wim Wenders, Paris, Texas. Christopher Nolan, Oppenheimer. Winner, Francis Ford Coppola, Apocalypse Now. The nominees for Best Picture go to Dazed and Confused, directed by Richard Linklater. All That Jazz, directed by Bob Fosse. Feels Good Man, directed by Arthur Jones. Blue Velvet, directed by David Lynch. Killers of the Flower Moon, directed by Martin Scorsese. Twin Peaks Fire Walk With Me, directed by David Lynch. Paris, Texas, directed by Wim Wenders. Oppenheimer, directed by Christopher Nolan. Blue Valentine, directed by Derek Cianfrance. Perfect Blue, directed by Satoshi Kon, Past Lives, directed by Celine Song, The Holdovers, directed by Alexander Payne, A Ghost Story, directed by David Lowry, The Four Seasons, directed by Alan Alda, Winner, Apocalypse Now, directed by Francis Ford Coppola.